ladies, please. Wait a minute. Has anyone seen my donkey?
Who are you calling donkey?
Inside me, now I'm big and sexy, and now you can ride me. Better than me, and he's leaving soon, so you better get a looking. He's constantly trained to travel in with someone pretty. Everyone give it up for Popeye, way too hot celebrity.
Human shredding, taking the scene from the
I will confess that I'm a little nervous that I won't know what... Oh my god, I love this musical. My name is Regina George.
Welcome back to your daily reminder of the day. It is May 4th, a Monday. About 8,000 Americans are injured by musical instruments each year. So like band kids, where are you shoving those trumpets?
Top 5 most problematic theater characters. Let's go! At number 5, you have JD from Heathers. He's a murderer, he's emotionally manipulative, and he's just not a good role model. At number 4, you have JD from Heathers. I don't get why some people find him attractive. Because there's nothing attractive about a serial killer who causes trauma to their girlfriend. At number 3, we have JD from Heathers. Did y'all forget about the scene where he literally breaks into Veronica's house and also makes a bunch of violent threats towards her? Why do people ship him with Veronica? I thought we were supposed to not ship that because he's a bad person. At number 2, we have Evan Hansen from Dear Evan Hansen. Just kidding, it's JD from Heathers again! Y'all really gonna call Evan a bad person when JD freaking murdered people? He's a psychopath! And at number 1, we have Phantom from Family Opera. Basically all the same problems as JD, except with a really uncomfortable age gap.
Alexander Hamilton. My name is Alexander Hamilton. And there's a million things I haven't done. But just you wait.
Finger Down, Theater Kid Edition, Part 2. Put a finger down if you were ever in a production of Grease and then your Rizzo had really long blonde hair and your director was like, she can't have that kind of hair, so we put her in a wig that was kind of like the movie, and then you end act one by all being at the park and you're all talking about the dance, and you play Roger and the guy who plays Duty are sitting next to each other, and you think the scene is going fine, but then Rizzo starts yelling at Kaneki, because that's how the scene goes, and she starts to attack him, and you stand up and go, fight, 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 and Danny Zuko has to grab Rizzo and pull her off of Kaneki, and then her wig comes tumbling down in that process and lands on the floor, and the whole audience is laughing because her wig just fell off, and she has her wig cap on, so it looks like she's bald, so your gut reaction is to, as a greaser, is to go, ah! And you literally scream on stage, and everyone kind of looks at you and starts laughing on stage and off stage, and our Rizzo is like, oh my gosh, how do I cover this up? So then she picks up her wig, turns to everyone on stage, and goes, shut up, I have cancer! And then she puts her wig back on, and then you have to sing, we go together, like Shyamalan, ka-ding-a-ding-a-ding-a-dong.
One of my pre-show rituals I like to do is there's a certain passage in the show that I find a little bit challenging, so I like to use that passage to warm up before the show while I'm getting ready. Go and look at all the poor guy's head is spinning. Poor guy's head is spinning. Go and look at all the poor guy's head is spinning.
Someone's in here.
Go and look at all the poor guys. Go and look at all the poor guys. Hey, head is spinning. Go and look at all the poor guys. Head is spinning.
What about us? What about it?
To some boy. I'm out here.
We're having a heart-to-heart. It's a hard discussion.
I know what we're about to discuss. We're about to discuss how you had me come out here to see you sing to some boy. We're going to discuss, who is he going to pay my gas? I'm leaving. This is enough.
Can you take me home, I guess?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I got nothing if I ain't got enough.
See 'em, I can show you what comes next, so don't be freaked. Stay in your seats. I do this bullshit like 8 times a week. So just relax.
It's a musical, a musical.
What is the Eagles? And I'm like peeing my pants.
I'm so excited. Oh my god.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You were so amazing.
Thanks, girl. Love you, Ashley.
Love you.
Okay, so I've had the honor of flying 2 different shows, one of those being Mary Poppins, which is the one you can see here. And here's a video for the first day of rehearsals for flying, and then the next day we added in costumes and music, and then we started running scenes and everything, so that was fun. And then finally, a few days later, we added in the cast and lighting and all the bunch of other stuff, and here's me flying in the actual show. So yeah.
Forever, there'll be music.
Embarrassing theater moment check.